Channel. I know you guys miss me. A lot has been going on. That is why I haven't been here. That is why I haven't actually released a video. A whole lot has been going on in my life. Many things, and we'll be talking about that in this video. Just before we go into the video, please like, share, subscribe, comment. I like to get you guys feedback. What you want me to do? What am I not doing right? What do you need me to do right? What topics do you want me to talk about? Just share what you think about the video, how you feel, whatever you want to do, just do it. But make sure you subscribe, like, share, subscribe, like, share. Three kind of actions. And comment. Actually, there are four. So welcome back to my channel. As I said, today I'll just be gisting and getting you guys up to speed with what's happening in my life. This past 2 weeks have been quite eventful, I must say. I've gone some, you know, enjoyment this past few weeks, and I just wanted to come up here and share with you guys what has been going on. I give you an update, life update. I'll tag this life update of what's going on now in my life. Yeah, because many interesting things have gone down, and I would like to share. So for those who don't know, and for those who already know, last week was my uncle's wedding, and this is not just any uncle. This is my favorite uncle. This is my fave, or my favorite. Actually, is my cousin. And it was a wonderful time, beautiful time, because we just enjoyed ourselves. It's a lot of enjoyment. So let me give you guys a backstory. Yeah, I and my uncle are very close, and I propose to be his groomswoman. Yes, one of his kind. First ever in my family. First ever groomswoman. Yeah, and I said I was gonna be the groomswoman because I just wanted to be very close to him. I wanted to feel like part of it, in whatever way I could. So being a groomswoman to me was a very good way of feeling part of the event. So I was nominated, or appointed. I appointed myself, actually. And I told my uncle that I was going to be his groomwoman, and he was quite excited. At first he wasn't excited, because he was thinking, oh, how is it going to be? Because of course his friends are not my age bracket, they're not in my age demographic. So he didn't, I'm sure he had reservations of how it will all play out in terms of communications and in terms of interactions with the grooms, men or women, as the case may be. So he had a bit of a hesitation with regards to that, and how, okay, family members are gonna take it and all of that. But in all, he was quite excited and he accepted it. He had no choice, actually. So he accepted it. That was going to be his groomwoman. Trust me, it didn't go down easily with family members, because obviously if you know a proper Nigerian wedding, you have gotten Ashwebi, do you understand? We have gotten Gili for the women, Ashwebi. So why will I be the one that will not wear the Ashwebi? Why will I be the one that everybody else is dressing like a girl, a woman, you know, proper Ashwebi, full on Ashwebi and Gili and whatnot, and I am there looking like a man and dressing like a man? So it didn't kind of sit well. They kind of made fun of me about it, but I was like, I was so determined that I was going to do it. and I was going to do it for my uncle. And not just because I wanted to do it for him, because I love him, and because I wanted to be on his train, and because I wanted to be part of it. I also did it because I wanted to know how it felt like to be a good woman. Do you understand? I haven't actually done that in my life. Surprise. So I just wanted to know how it felt like to be a groomswoman. I'd seen it on a couple of people, Kemi Adetiba did it for Banky. A couple of other people had done it for like their friends, very close guy friends. And this was family, obviously, so I wanted to do it. I didn't care what anybody was going to say. Anyway, it was too late to even go back. Yeah. So yeah, the whole Naya suit, and the agbada. So I'll put pictures. You see my pictures. Guys, I killed this thing, man. I killed it. You know. So if you know a typical Nigerian wedding, you know that of course relatives from far and near is gonna come. So I had people come from outside the country. It was quite nice. I really like when weddings happen because it brings another level of energy. Or especially in family gatherings, because everybody's around, there's a full house, there's full energy, there's just laughter. There's just something about when everybody's family is just around. I don't know, it gives me this homely feeling. Forgive me, I'm looking to my right. I'm giving you guys updates on what has been happening in my life. But I needed to write it down so that I don't forget what I wanted to talk about, because it's easy to just rant and ramble. So yes, I'll put it, and I also put a video of myself being a beauty. Do you understand? I was dropping it like it was hot on the dance floor. Particular videographer that was pulling me around, because I was so busy. I was so busy with you know, groomswoman duties and just, you know, catering to them, because it's a big day. Everything, anybody that is getting married should not stress on their big day. So whatever you need to do, if you need to carry their leg, if you need to hold their hand, if you need to get something for them, 100%. Those are duties of the groomswoman, the groomwoman or the groomman, or the bridesmaids also. So those are duties that need to be done. So I was quite busy. I couldn't vlog. I really wanted to vlog. I laughed at myself so hard, because when will I have the time to vlog? And it so happened that my phone even died halfway in, into the day. My phone had died. I just gave up. I didn't even start, to be quite honest. I didn't even start. Ah, shout out to my baby girl for this lovely neck piece. It's so cute. Yeah, so I didn't even start, to be quite honest. But yeah, so it was a large gathering. It was a one-day event. We had trad at the hotel, the hall. We had trad quite early. So I wore my agbada, you know, did my thing. I'll put a video here of, you know, so my cousin gassing me up in my agbada after trad. We went straight on to change for the white wedding and church wedding. I'll also give you a little snippet into what I look like in that regard. And it was reception time after church, you know. Let me backtrack a bit. So before the event, I had not done a day before the event. It was on Saturday. So by Friday, I hadn't done my nails. I needed to get my nails done. So guess what? I knew that I was too late to go to the place I trusted to do the nails. So I went to a guy that I knew that. Funny enough, guys are doing these things now. So I went to a guy that I knew could do nails also. So he did something really quick. I didn't need it. Just press on and gel paint and all that. He did it. And guess what? By the next day, it had already come off. One of it was already off. I'm like, if I hear, I said I'm going back. Guess what? I went back and this is what came. Guys, see my nails. It's much better now. I had to go back because everything was peeling. At one point, nearly this finger went off of my. I'm like, what did he fix for me? I had to go back there. Shishi, I did not pay. Shishi. So now back to the wedding. So we can come back for a reception, you know, all that. Man. Guys, let me just. So you know there are certain people that, of course, there are certain money packers and money changers. Those are very essential people in a Nigerian wedding. Because whether you like it or not, you're going to be spraying money, right? And you need people that will pack. So people that will pack are usually like younger siblings or like cousins. Younger ones in the family are usually dedicated and prestigious. That precious duty to pack the money. Guys, let me just tell you this. It is not a small thing. If you see all those people that are packing money in events, respect them, my dear. Respect them. So at some point, I was packing money. Then at some point, because I knew that, of course, money has to be made in a Nigerian party. In fact, in any party, when money is being spread, money has to be made, yeah? So, and coupled with the fact that of recent, the money used to change naira to like mint is quite expensive and is rare, like it's scarce rather in the banks. They don't just give mint anyhow. Like before, you could just go and get mint at a cheaper price. Like maybe if you want to change 1,000, they give you 5 naira, you pay 5 naira or 10 naira or something, or 100 naira for each 1,000 or so. But now it's like quite expensive, more expensive than it used to be. So what now happens now is that there's more work on the changer at the event. Yeah, so people are packing money, then people are coming to change money. Guys, do not underestimate the value of the exchanger at a wedding. So if somebody, or a party rather, if somebody comes and says, oh, I want to change 50,000 like to 200 naira, that is where you know that either you know mass or you don't know mass. That's where you know that either you don't know mass and you can't carry your calculator and calculate your thing. Okay, 250,000 divided by 200, you know the number of pieces of 200 that you give the person, or you'll be forming, don't worry, I know mass, I calculate it. It's not a job. I respect bankers and all these accountants that keep record. Hey, and the people that want to transfer. Ha, guys, I was knackered, I was tired, but money has to be made. So I was collecting all the collectibles I could collect. Then it got to a point that after things have settled down a bit and we went into the after party, I'm like, man, I am in this party also. I need to enjoy myself. I need to enjoy myself, guys. I need to enjoy myself. Then I just took a pause and I enjoyed myself. I danced. If you know me in a party, I have energy. You understand? Just that party day. I may be tired after all, but that night or that evening or that afternoon, whatever. Let's go! energy is 100%. So it was just, it was a beautiful moment. I was just over the moon. The next day I had to go to church also. The next day I went to church, my legs felt it. My legs felt it. My body, in fact, felt that I had done something. Do you understand? So that was one of the few things that went on. Also, so I've just been working I'm looking for how to grow my YouTube channel. Let me know if you like. I haven't done that much. I haven't done that much, but please, you should help me. I don't know what else to do. I'm new to this thing. Help me and subscribe to my channel. Like, comment, share to your friends, your family members, and all of them that, yeah, you have seen one beautiful girl and she knows how to talk very well. I like her channel, I like her energy, I like her vibe. So yeah, that's one thing I was kind of thinking about. Was one of the things I was going through this past 2 weeks. Also, I had an interview done. I was quite nervous for that. I was quite nervous because a lot is at stake, but I had an interview done and I hope I did well. I was quite tense. You know, all these interviews that we know that is a big deal. It's a very big deal, so I had it done and I hope for the best. There was a signing of contract, but so one of the most interesting that also happened to me this past 2 weeks was that, let me also give you a backstory of this. I had gotten my driver's license. I've gotten my driver's license for a while now. I've been driving, but just within the neighborhood. So last week, this week was the first time I drove out of my jurisdiction. It was the first time I drove out of my jurisdiction. Guys, it was not easy. I don't know how people do it with Google Map and whatnot. Hey, let me just leave that just for another day. Man, it wasn't so bad because I obviously had my AirPods in, so it was directing me as I was going on. But you know, it's tricky sometimes when it says in 300 meters you're turning left and you feel like, oh, I should have gone to 300 meters, turn left, and that's not the left that you're supposed to turn. So at the end of the day, you have made a mistake that will take you back maybe another mile. But it was quite interesting. I was very pumped about it because they have underestimated me too much in my house. That it's not yet time. Like, underdogs also need the opportunity. Yes, let the underdog shine. So I was quite excited about that. So that's it. Finally got. So for those that knew, I've had my AirPods. It was a gift from my aunt, but the thing was that she misplaced the other ear. I couldn't find it, so I've been using one ear on my AirPods for a while, but I finally got the second one. Guys, I finally got the second one. I'm so excited because my friends that have yapped me, the ones that have called me one year girl or one year AirPods girl, my God has put it to shame. Yes, I'm going to call their names out. Shionpo is the number one on this list. I'm number one on this team. Yes, I know you will watch this video. I have gotten my second year of my AirPods, so it's a complete set now. So that's one of things. I just had fun. Then after everything, guys, I miss my uncle so much. I miss him so much. So yeah, you know that time, you know all those times where you have like, you kind of separate from friends. For example, the most prominent one that happens is when you're leaving secondary school and you're going to university and you're like, I will never forget my friend. Is it a lie? There's certain people right now that you just will remember. Just that it's difficult keeping in touch. So there are certain people, of course, there are certain people that obviously you still once in a while try to he reach out and you guys talk and just and gets back to normal. But it's never some people, it's never just like a one-way street, like it's not just a straight line to the whole thing. So friendships have suffered because of distance and you know all of that. But you know that time in secondary school, when you're in secondary school and you're in touch and in touch and in touch, then university, then you make new friends, but for that period in time you're missing them when you just left school. So it's something like that withdrawal withdrawal moment from someone is quite hard. But then you know that of course it's for a greater good, it's for a greater thing. Like of course you guys are going to university, or he's getting married and he's progressing in life, which is a good thing. But obviously you miss the person. It doesn't stop you from missing the person and just wanting that kind of, it's just that there's going to be like a shift and a change in the way things used to be. It's just going to happen. Whether it's your secondary school, your university friend, whatever it's going to be, the dynamic has kind of shifted. Things, new things are going to be happening in your life. Life is going to be going on, and you may not just be, it may not just be carried along like you used to. But don't hold it. Like I saw something, or was it a video or something I watched or read? Don't be angry with your friends. Especially my friends from maybe secondary school or from university, keep in touch is hard. People are trying to figure out their lives, they're trying to know what they want, what they like, what their future will be like. They're trying to plan it. So it's a lot. They're going through what you are also going through. So it's not a one-sided thing. If a friend is not reaching out, please reach out. You don't know what's going on. That person may be suffering from depression. That person may be feeling less than. Person may not be feeling adequate for that relationship, or that person may just, you know, just be going through something that if you don't ask, you'll never know, right? So please reach out to your friends. That's just a side note. Yeah, so that's pretty much what has been going on with me for this past 2 weeks. Quite a lot, right? So I think that's been good enough. I had friends over, we shot a video, I think I released that, I also released that soon enough. Yeah, just keep watching me. And one very important thing, I want to have a mukbang. Now I'm looking for the people. It can be one person, it can be a set of people that will sponsor my mukbang. I'm sure you heard in my introduction video, but I'm a foodie, I like it. If I'm going to have a mukbang, I need proper, you know, those other videos that this IO creator guy used to give people turkey and then chicken and things that they will eat. Yes, I want that kind of plate. Let me know that I'm doing a mukbang. Let me, you know, and I just ideas. Person that will sponsor me, you know, comment below. Yeah, but that should be fun. I think I'll get a mukbang very soon. Thank you guys for listening to my story, my life updates that I'm giving you guys. Miss you guys. So please subscribe now. Yeah, subscribe. You just do it already. I'm begging you, subscribe, share, like, comment. You're welcome to the family. Let's just have fun, enjoy ourselves, chill. Oh my goodness, take a look at my ha. Okay, don't worry. It's coming through. My skin secret is coming very soon. Thank you guys for watching. See you later. Peace. I know they don't want me the money to come my way.
them know. I no go let the money to come my way.